Good morning and welcome to the Vinny Testaverde Show. I'm Michael Stanley, and this, of course, is the man of the hour, number 12, the starting quarterback for the Cleveland Browns, Vinny Testaverde. How you doing, man?
I'm doing great. How you doing?
I'm doing fine. I'm all pumped up. Here we are, first game today. It's got to be an exciting time. Is the first game of the season, like, I mean, everything's optimistic and everything?
Well, we're very optimistic this year. I think this game is even extra exciting because it's an interstate rivalry against the Cincinnati Bengals, and aside from being a division game, you know, our team is pumped up and ready to go.
Now, before we get into some of the football stuff, I don't know if a lot of people really know a lot about Vinny Testaverde. You're a Brooklyn guy, right? Long Island and Brooklyn and all that?
Yeah, I was born in Brooklyn and actually moved to Long Island when I was very young and grew up on Long Island, where I grew up with four sisters, along with my mother and father, of course.
Now, is that kind of a big shock going from that there down to Miami?
It was, because I left my family. It was just a tough transition for me to leave home for the first time and go down to the University of Miami, where I met some great friends and great teammates as well.
Now, you're a married man, right? And you got a daughter?
Yes, I've been married for almost 4 years, and to my wife, Mitzi, and we have a daughter, Alicia Marie.
All right. How are you liking the Cleveland area?
Cleveland's been great. It reminds me a lot of back home in New York, the change of seasons, and you know, a lot of people think I'm crazy because I actually like the winter time, but I guess I like it because I get a chance to leave it when I want, because my home now is in Florida.
Well, if you really like the winter time, you can come help me with my snow in the driveway sometime during the year.
I'd be glad to.
Now, you guys have a real successful preseason, 3-1. Do you put much stock in the preseason? I mean, fans, I think most fans, even though they say, oh, it's the preseason, I think most of them still say, boy, we want to go undefeated and we want to see this and we want to see that. What do you guys feel about it?
Well, I think as a team, you can't put a lot of stock into it, but at the same time, I think it's good for our team to go out and win games, get used to that feeling of winning, just being able to continue that week after week winning streak, I think is important for us to get used to, so that once we do get into the season, that'll carry over and continue our win streak throughout the season.
Now, obviously, people are saying that the defense is pretty solid this year, but there's been a lot of upheaval on the offensive line, which has to be near and dear to your heart. Is that kind of make getting the whole thing together a little bit harder?
Well, I think the offensive line is the most important unit within a football team, because it takes them the longest period of time to come together as a unit so they can play well on offense. And the thing about offense is, if one player makes a mistake, it can kill a whole play. But on defense, if even nine players make a mistake, there's still that one guy that can make the sack or knock down the pass, so the play's over and they can come up 2nd and 10.
Now, a lot of fans for the last couple of years have been on Coach Belichick to have an offensive coordinator. This year we do, with Mr. Crosby. How do you get along with him?
I think it's a great move for our team and for Coach Belichick, because he's involved in a lot of other areas on our team, along with personnel moves that go on throughout the year. So doing this and giving Steve Crosby the offensive coordinator position takes pressure off of Bill, and also gives another coach a chance to look at the complete package on offense, see what we have, put things together, put a good game plan together, and go into that week and beat whoever we're playing that week.
And today it is Cincinnati. And one of the faces that's going to be there is a familiar face, one of my favorite Browns of all time, and we'll meet him when we return, Mr. Ernest Biner. Welcome back to the Vinny Testaverde Show. I'm Michael Stanley, and joining Vinny and me right now on the set, as I said earlier, one of my favorite Cleveland Browns of all time, Mr. Ernest Biner. Good to have you back in town, man.
It's good to be back.
Is it weird to be coming back to Cleveland? I mean, you were here for so long and then so successful in Washington, and bang, here we go.
Oh, yeah. It was definitely a little mystical when we first got back, and got out on the field and looked at the Browns emblem on the building over there, but it was not a big question as far as whether we could come back or not. It was real nice. We're excited about it.
Did it surprise you when the overtures were made to get you coming back?
Oh yeah, oh yeah. I thought it was a little bit of a joke. Somebody was playing a joke on me. But when things got serious, they really wanted me to come back, and we're looking for me to contribute in, you know, some different ways.
Well, I'll tell you what, as I said before, it made a lot of Browns fans smile, I think the majority of them, because I think you play the game the way it's supposed to be played. You played against him before now.
Yeah, I'll tell you, Michael, it not only makes the fans excited, it makes the players on the Browns team excited too. And Yes, we've played against Ernest, and I'm just glad he's on our side running the ball because he's certainly had some great runs. You know, the thing that when Ernest first got here that I noticed about him is that he went out and worked harder than anybody on the football field. Studies his notes in the classroom part of it harder than anybody I've seen. I think, you know, Ernest brings a lot of experience to our team, and this is, you know, a player that certainly anyone would love to have on their team, and we're glad that we have him with us.
Now, what he really means by all that is you're a good blocker, and that's going to help him a lot out there.
Exactly. To pick up that blitz is crucial.
What do you see as your role on the team this year?
Well, I think my biggest role has thus far been to provide the type of leadership that Vinny just explained, being able to go out and work hard, show the guys what it really takes, just to really be an example. Now, as far as the season is concerned, and you know what is actually what are they looking for me to do there? It's not really clear. The guys that are going to get the main action is Eric, Leroy, and Tommy out of the backfield. And as long as they're playing well, I'll be their biggest cheerleaders.
It's got to be a great thing though for a team to know that if one of these guys, hopefully not one of them gets hurt, but even if they're just taking a breather, you know, and all of a sudden the defense lightens up, but then they say, you come in the game, it's going to be like, oh no, here comes Biner, now we got to bear down again, you know? It's going to be a good feeling for you.
Yeah, it is. To be in this situation, especially in this stage of my career, it's a nice setup for me to be able to come in and, you know, maybe to relieve somebody or either take over a game if necessary.
How much is made of guys that bring leadership to the locker room and to the field. Is this really important thing? Do you get this usually from the veterans?
Well, certainly. It's very important to our team, especially when you have some younger players on the team that really are looking for those examples by some experienced players to lead them in the right direction. And certainly with the experience that Ernest has and the places where he's been, such as the Super Bowl and you know, those are the type of people that even myself look to and look up to as a leader.
You played on some great Browns teams. How does this one shape up, to those?
Well, what I see is a lot of talent on this team. People are learning how to practice, are learning what it takes to be a championship team. We have the ability, we have the mentality now. We have the right mixture of older younger veterans and the ones that are right in the middle of their careers, and I think we definitely have the makings for a team that can first of all make the playoffs and then to attain home field and to go on from there.
Well, I thank you for stopping by today. Good luck against the Bengals today, and it's great to have you back in town, and have a safe and healthy season.
Thanks. It's good to see you, other than on that barbarian video.
Hey, remember that? That was a good time. Mike Babb punching out bears. Boy, that's another story altogether, folks. And we have another one when we return. We'll show you another side of the Brown center, Steve Everett, right after this. Welcome back to the Vinny Testaverde Show. You know, Vinny, I think that most Browns fans would agree that the pick of number 61 in the draft a couple years ago was one of the best ones we've had in a long time. What do you think of Steve Everett?
Steve Everett certainly has played great for the Cleveland Browns. This is a guy that came in as a rookie and played like a seasoned veteran from day one. And the center position is one of two of the most important positions on the offense, and because he has to get up there and make all the line calls for the rest of the offensive line to block either the run schemes or the pass schemes, and then that filters down through the rest of the players on offense. So I think Steve's going to be a great one, and he's going to play here for a long time in Cleveland.
Well, Steve kind of looks like a wild man, but there's another side to him. Let's take a look at what we found out.
Probably as long as I've been involved in football. From as early as I can remember, my father had me, not like a special school, but taking special art classes, probably elementary school. And then through junior high school, I was taking some special courses. And most of my high school times when I was working with art was spent getting a portfolio ready to send away to a college. went ahead and sent it to the Michigan Art School and got accepted. And then, you know, once I got to college is when I really started, you know, focusing on the painting. More focused than just painting, I've been just doing pretty much watercolors, which I think is probably the toughest medium paint-wise to use because it dries so quickly, and it's not like oils where if you screw up you can wait for it to dry and go back over it. I mean, it's a one-shot deal, so I think if you come up with something in the watercolors, it's almost more, you know, you almost get more satisfaction out of it just because you realize that it's, you know, you don't get a second chance with the paints. I had a show in, I think, late February, early March, where I had about six pieces up, and there was about four other artists, and it was a really nice show. And my father was there, and he was telling me that people were coming up and actually offering, you know, money, which I never thought would happen, never expected. And I actually didn't have anything up for sale at the time, so the opportunity was there, but I just kind of wanted to hang on. I feel awkward trying to put a price on, you know, any number I come up with just seems too high that someone would actually want to pay that much for something I did. But yeah, hopefully I'm going to have a show, you know, in this upcoming off season, and yeah, hopefully get started with selling some original pieces. And I also have a limited edition, some prints that are coming out sometime in the near future, and hopefully, you know, that'll go over well and people will accept it. I mean, I don't even know if that many of the guys know that I do it. They really only see the side of me in the meeting rooms where I'm drawing pictures of, you know, guys like Tommy and Gene Williams and just guys on the team that have those, you know, caricature features that I don't really even have to expand on too much, you know. But it just keeps the meetings a little light. If it's something you love and if it's something that you really have your heart set on, I mean, you can't give it up. It's probably going to be a long road, and you might have to put it on hold every now and then, and, you know, maybe get a, like I said, get a real job and just kind of keep that on the side. But, you know, I mean, if you're good enough, you got to remember there's always someone out there that's probably a better football player than you or a better artist than you, you know, has more pure talent. But, you know, you can make up for it, and, you know, just being excited about wanting to do it and, you know, putting your heart into it and trying to reach your goal.
What do you think, huh?
That's pretty impressive.
He's good.
Yeah, he's very good.
What do you do to kick back when you're not thinking about or playing football?
Well, actually, I used to do some abstract paintings myself a few years ago, but hey, that's a...
The entire brand.
That's a whole different program.
They're all painters. That's great. Well, this was real neat. We're going to try to find out more about the guys on the team as we go through the year, what they do that isn't really totally football related. Now, when we return, we're going to find out about today's game. We'll see what Vinny thinks about the upcoming contest with the Bengals down in the jungle right after this. Welcome back to the Vinny Testaverde Show. And with just a little over an hour to go till kickoff down in Cincinnati, I know what you're wondering. You're going, how is this guy going to get there and take care of business, get dressed, and get everything together? Don't worry. He's really good. He'll take care of it. What do you think about the Bengals? What kind of problems do these guys present to you today?
You know, the first thing that catches my eye on film is that they're a much improved team over a year ago. They seem to be playing very consistent on defense. You know, the thing that really popped out at me is that they're blitzing a lot on second down rather than your normal third down situations and even mixing it up on first down. So the things we expect from them is to play with a man deep, don't give up the big plays, give us the underneath stuff, and blitz on second down, try and knock us into third and long situations. And if we can keep ourselves out of those third and long situations, come up third and one, third and two, it should be a good day for the Browns.
Now, even though he is a rookie, what's the first pick in the draft? I mean, it's got to be a little scary to look over the line and see Mr. Wilkinson over there. This guy's a big guy.
They call him Big Daddy.
That's true.
He looks big on film, too, and he certainly has some quick feet. He's a power rusher, and we're going to need to, at times, get two guys on him, double him up, and and keep him from getting to the quarterback, which is me, of course. So I'd be happy if we can accomplish that feat.
What do you think about David Klingler? Here comes a very highly touted quarterback out of Houston, and he's had kind of a rough entry into the NFL. Well, how good do you think this guy can actually be?
Well, David has a lot of talent, and I think the more that he learns this system, the more that he plays in his system, he's going to become a very efficient quarterback. And, you know, you look at that last preseason game, and I think they scored the first four out of five offensive series that they had the ball, and really it looked like they were playing like they were in the Super Bowl.
Now, is this a good feeling for you? Because actually your first start last year was against the Bengals, three TD passes and the victory and all that, and that would be a nice sort of thing to redo again, wouldn't it?
It certainly would, but I think these are going to be some different circumstances. This is the first game of the year for us, for them as well. Everybody on both teams has great expectations of their upcoming season. It's their first game again. They're going to have a sold-out crowd. It's going to be noisy for us, but I think, you know, if we go in there and do our jobs and keep our situations in those third and shorts, third and one, third and two, that we should be very successful against the Cincinnati Bengals come this Sunday.
Mark Carrier had a little sort of a rough week health-wise. Is he going to be okay 100%?
Mark's feeling pretty good. You know, I talked to him throughout the week because he was hurting earlier in the week, but later in the week he said he was back to 100%, so we expect some great things from Mark today.
Was that a nice thing with you coming to this team with somebody that you actually had somebody that you knew how to hook up with right away?
Oh, definitely. Coming to a new team, a new city, just being able to see a friendly face, a guy that you know, Mark's a guy that I've spent six seasons with back in Tampa, and then 1 year last year, so we've been together for quite some time, and just to be able to feel that comfort going into a game with him out there really gives me confidence to go out and play.
Now, it always seems like more weird things happen on the first day in an NFL season than any other day. I mean, it's just kind of like, well, here we go, and anything can happen. Do the players feel like that, too?
Well, no. I think the players really feel excited about this season. You know, we have so much talent on our team that the players can't wait to get started, and this is what we've been waiting for. We all feel like it's going to be a great year, and it's going to be a Super Bowl year.
That's what we like to hear. That's definitely what we like to hear. Bengals, look out. Number 12 and the guys coming at you. We'll be taking a little break right now, but when we come back, we'll meet our very own special member of the Dog Pound. Well, Vinny, I think by now you know it's good to have the Dog Pound on your side. And there's one dog you haven't met yet, and I think it's time to do that. Let's meet Petey, okay?
And now, it's time for Petey, the prognosticating pooch. Petey, a longtime Browns fan and original member of the Dog Pound, has fine-tuned his prognosticating powers from the neon nightlife of Las Vegas to the sun-drenched casinos of Monte Carlo. And now, it's time for Vinny, Michael, and Petey to match wits on this week's Monday Night Game.
Okay, we got the 49ers at home to the Raiders. Raiders getting 7.5. Who do you like on this?
I think this is the year the Raiders will go to the AFC Championship game, but of course, lose to the Browns. I like the Raiders.
He likes the Raiders. Well, I cannot go against Jerry Rice and those guys. I mean, the 49ers, I got to go with the 49ers. I'll give the points. Let's see who Petey likes here, okay?
Okay, let's check it out.
Okay, here he comes. Going at the 10, at the 5. He likes the Raiders.
Attaboy, Petey.
Pete's going with the points.
He's going with the winner.
Well, you know, we're going to tally this up all season long. So it's I have the 49ers. You guys got the Raiders. Well, we'll see what happens. Hey, and we'll see what happens in an hour. Good luck today.
Thanks, Michael.
Take it to them down in the jungle. Have a safe one. Bring home a winner. And we'll see you all back here next week.